have their voice heard.
It must become a clear reach out. The record number of Americans of all races, faiths, religions chose change over more of the same. They've given us a mandate for action on COVID, the economy, climate change, systemic racism. They made it clear. They want the country to come together, not continue to pull apart. The people spoke. More than 74 million Americans. And they spoke loudly for our ticket. But while we're waiting for the final results, I want people to know we're not waiting to get the work done and start the process. Yesterday, Senator Harris and I held meetings with groups of experts on public health and the economic crisis this country is facing. The pandemic, as you also know, is getting more worrisome all across the country. Daily cases are skyrocketing, and it's now believed that we could see as many as 200,000 cases in a single day. The death toll is approaching 240,000 lives lost to this virus. That's 240,000 empty chairs, kitchen tables, and dining room tables all across America. We'll never be able to measure all that pain and the loss, the suffering that so many families have experienced. We know something about what it feels like to lose to someone. It feels like to lose someone. And I want them to know they're not alone. Our hearts break with you. We want everyone to know on day one, we're going to put our plan to control this virus into action. We can't save any of the lives lost, any of those who've been lost, but we can save them. Senator Harris and I also heard yesterday about how this recovery is slow because of the failure to get the pandemic under control. More than 20 million people are on unemployment. Millions are worried about making rent and putting food in the table. Our economic plan will put a focus on a path to a strong recovery. Look, we both know tensions are high and can be high after a tough election, one like we've had. But we need to remember, we have to remain calm, patient. Let the process work out as we count all. You know, we're proving again what we proved for 244 years in this country. Democracy works. Your vote will be counted. I don't care how hard people try to stop it. I will not let it happen. The people will be heard. Our journey is toward a more perfect union, and it keeps moving on. In America, we hold strong views. We have strong disagreements, and that's okay. Strong disagreements are inevitable in a democracy. And strong disagreements are healthy. They're a sign of a vigorous debate, of deeply held views. But we have to remember, the purpose of our politics isn't total, unrelenting, unending warfare. No. The purpose of our politics, the work of the nation, isn't to fan the flames of conflict, but to solve problems, to guarantee justice, to give everybody a fair shot, to improve the lives of our people. We may be opponents, but we're not enemies. We're Americans. No matter who you voted for, I'm certain of one thing. The vast majority of the 150 million Americans who voted, they want to get the vitriol out of our politics. We're certainly not going to agree on a lot of issues, but at least we can agree to be civil to one another. We have to put the anger and the demonization behind us. It's time for us to come together as a nation to heal. It's not going to be easy. We have to try. My responsibility as president will be to represent the whole nation. I want you to know that I'll work as hard for those who voted against me as those who voted for me. That's the job. That's the job. It's called the duty of care for all Americans. We have serious problems with you. From COVID, the economy, to racial justice, to climate change. We don't have any more time to waste on partisan warfare. You know, and more than that, we have such an incredible opportunity to build the future we want for our kids and our grandkids. I've said many, many times, we I've never been more optimistic about the future of this nation. There is no reason we can't live in the 21st century. We just need to remember who we are. This is the United States of America. There's never been anything we've been unable to do, unable to accomplish, and we've done it together. I hope to be talking to you tomorrow. I want to thank you all, and may God bless you, and may God protect our troops. Good night.
Well, we heard a lot of the themes you would hear if that was a victory speech.
How about the, I hope to be talking to you tomorrow with an interesting line.
I heard the victory speech. Mm-hmm. I thought it was really interesting that the themes were the themes that he rode to victory. If it was going to be a victory, that's what he's been focusing on. COVID, solving the economic problems, linking those together, healthcare, and unifying the country. That was the message he tried to deliver.
I think it's also important to remember here, as everyone is increasingly anxious and worried about the fact that this race has not yet been called by us or other networks, that Joe Biden again emphasized trust the process. He said, patience, be patient. And that, we should underscore, I think, is something we haven't heard a lot of from this president. It's a contrast with what we've had from President Trump for 4 years, to have somebody who is getting up there and saying, no, let them do it right. Even if it's not fast, even if it's not instant gratification, do it right. And I think that's a message to his supporters.
Maybe it's a message to them.